Good morning friends, welcome to today's artificial intelligence class. And today we are going to see the statistical learning methods, which is the second part of 5th unit and another important question in 5th unit. The statistical learning methods are based on learning of uncertainty in the real environment. That is, the environment is uncertain environment. On these uncertain environment, the statistical learning agent will learn those environment. Here two theories are very important. First one is probability theory and decision theory. And by using these two theory, the agent will learn this particular uncertain environment. And it will learn this probabilistic theory by means of experience. And apart from this, the Bayesian view of learning is extremely powerful, which provides a general solution to the problem of noise, overfitting and optimal predictions. So these are the statistical learning methods. The statistical learning is about inferences, and here the idea is generated from data and hypothesis, and these are called as key terms of statistical learning. Data and hypothesis are key terms of statistical learning. Here, data is nothing but samples and populations. By using these samples and populations only, we are going to do this hypothesis. And these are otherwise called as evidence, evidence of this particular learning method. And now let us see one simple example for this statistical learning method, surprise candy world. Here we are having two different types of candies. First one is cherry candy and second one is lime candy. Here cherry candy is very sweet and many people like this cherry candy, and lime candy is not that much sweet and most of the people don't like this lime candy. But instead of using the same color wrapper for those candies, the manufacturer using the same opaque wrapper, and the user cannot identify whether this particular candy is cherry or lime. And now the candies will be packed with very large bag, just like our marble chocolate bag, and we cannot see the combination of candies inside that bag. And there are five different combinations there. First one is full cherry, that is hypothesis one is 100% cherry. And second combination is 75% cherry and 25% lime. And third combination is 50% cherry, 50% lime. And fourth combination is 25% cherry and 25% lime. And fifth combination is 100% lime. So 100% cherry, 75% cherry and 25% lime. And 50% cherry, 50% lime. And 25% cherry, 50% lime, sorry, 75% lime and 100% lime candies. So we cannot see what combination of cherries there inside the bag from the outside, because they are packed with very large bag and we cannot identify from outside. There are five kinds of bags, and the manufacturer produces 10% of 100% cherry candy bags and 10% of 100% lime candy bags, and they will produce 20% of 75% cherry and 25% lime bag, and 20% of 25% cherry and 75% lime bags, and the manufacturer will produce 40% of 50% cherry and 50% lime candies. So the manufacturer will produce 10% of only cherry candies and 10% of only lime candies, and 20% of 75% cherry and 25% lime candy bags, and 20% of 25% cherry and 75% lime candy bags, and 40% of 50% cherry and 50% lime candy bags. These bags will be more. And suppose we are going to take any one bag, and we don't know what kind of bag this is. What kind of bag means we don't know which kind of bag it is. And suppose we open that bag and we will take one candy means we don't know which candy that will be. We are randomly pick one candy bag and the variable is H, and we don't know which type of bag this is. We are having five different types of bags, H1 through H5. we don't know which pack we picked randomly, and here H is not directly observable. And we open the bag and we will take one piece of candy, and the candies inside the bag are n different candies, and in our example we are having 8 different candies in a bag D1 to Dn. Here D8, where Di is random variable which is possible value of cherry or lime, which candy we picked randomly from the bag. And the problem is actually predict the flavor of next piece of candy. We don't know which candy will be the next, either lime candy or cherry candy. So the agent need to learn the theory of its uncertain environment world. Here the Bayesian learning is very much useful to calculate the probability of each hypothesis, and here D represent the data or evidence by the observed value D, that is small d. And the Bayes rule is probability of Hi gives D, which is equal to alpha into probability of D gives Hi into probability of Hi. And this is the Bayesian equation to predict the unknown quantity X based on the D, that is given data or evidence. The Bayesian equation is summation of I probability of X gives H of I into probability of H of I gives D, which is used to predict the weighted average over the prediction of individual hypothesis. We are having 5 different types of bags, and randomly we can pick any one bag and we can take any one candy from that bag, and we need to calculate the probability of that particular candy. Here the candy is X. So here the Bayesian approach, we are having two key quantities. First one is prior hypothesis P of Hi and likelihood of the data under each hypothesis, that is probability of D gives Hi. First we will see the prior distribution over all the candy bags, that is manufacturer will produce 5 different types of candy bags. First one is H1. H1 is 100% cherry candies, the probability is 0.1 prior probability. And the second type of candy bag is H2, the probability of 0.2, that is 75% cherry candies and 25% lime candies. And the third type is H3. The probability is 0.4, that is 50% cherry candy and 50% lime candy. And the fourth type is H4 is 0.2, that is 75% lime candy and 25% cherry candy. And the last one is H5 is 0.1, that is 100% lime candy. And this is the prior probability of all the given candy bags. And next we are going to find the likelihood of the given data, that is all the candy bags. Here we are having 5 different candy bags, so we need to do the product of all the likelihoods. What's the equation for computing likelihood? Probability of D, that is given data, gives H of I, which is equal to product of J, probability of DJ gives H of I. So this is the computation of prior distribution and likelihood. This diagram explains the predicted probability of next candy is lime candy based on the this Bayesian equation with respect to H5, which is H5, this contains all lime candies. If all the candies are lime candies, then this will go towards 1, so it will increase towards 1. In the hypothesis 5, all candies are lime candies, then the next candy should be lime only, hence the flow will go towards 1. And suppose if we take H4, here 75% of candies are lime candies and 25% are cherry candies, so the equation result will gives like this. And the third one is 50% lime and 50% cherry, 50% lime and 50% cherry. So this is the curve for this particular equation. And the next one is H2. This is 75% cherry and only 25% lime candy. So this one here, this is the equation. And the first one, H1, is all are only cherry candies and no lime candies are here. So this is the curve for this first H1. Here I explain the very basic things about the statistical learning method, and I will share the detailed notes to you. And this is the question time. Define statistical learning method. This is only 2-mark question. Don't give the detailed answer, students, and give very short answer in the comment box. Thank you, all of you.